2019. It's showtime, Woo! Jeffrey. Woo! We're back. Podcast in the studio.
It's New Year's Day. We are no.
No, it's not.
No,
it's well past New Year's. It's a week plus later.
took a week to sleep that off.
We have not been in the audio studio in how long?
November?
I'm going to look at, mid-November is the last time we were in the audio studio.
Well, that's dereliction of duty, sir.
Well, no, it isn't because we had, I don't know if we're going to talk any about your holiday.
Only if you ask. It's the Major Nelson Show.
Well,
not
it is.
Jeff's
I always
want to,
you are a guest slash co-host slash important cog.
Slash last man standing.
You know, I was thinking about this because this podcast has had quite an illustrious career for the past, how many years, Jeffrey? 13? 14?
Yeah, we were talking about this
Ian
yesterday.
Here, who I've got to get back on. Steptoe, may he rest in peace. Indeed. Who, by the way, I was thinking about him. You know, I don't know if you didn't work a lot with Steptoe, but he loved politics.
I followed him on Twitter. We would chat here and there, and I'm like, you say all the things that I want to say.
He would love what was going on in the United States political
Loves
scene.
Loves it. Right? An interesting term.
Yeah, so he would be fascinated by it. Of course,
fascinated, yes.
Laura, of course, who is now...
We still see Laura.
In fact, I was just texting her this morning. She's been traveling, and she's been busy. She told me she misses the show.
Well, the show misses her.
Yeah, so, but it's Absolutely. You and I are back here. We did a video show, we did an audio show, we're back in the studio. And how was your holiday, though?
It was fantastic.
Do you want to talk about your traveling?
I mean, if you want to hear about it. I
want to hear about the first part. I really don't care about the second part.
Really?
Yeah.
So, we decided to take like a big trip. We don't often get to do that.
That's not true. You do it once a year.
We do it once a year. But, well, a lot of times we only get to, I don't get to travel too much. I travel so much during work.
Sure, of course.
During the year. And I don't really know where I'm going to be. And so I really don't take vacation during the year at all. And so I kind of save it all up for the end of the year.
And you do.
And we went to New Zealand. But about halfway between the West Coast and New Zealand is French Polynesia. So we stopped there for a couple of
Tahiti.
Days. I mean, yeah, that's one of those islands.
When you say that, it sounds really exotic.
It does.
It is.
Well, it's a couple hours south of Hawaii, and Hawaii is great. But if you live on the West Coast, Hawaii is, you can go all the time. They have a Costco.
The way I described this was, you and I grew up on the East Coast of the United States.
Yes.
Is like in New England, much like Philly, I guess, is like when you need some sun, you take the two-hour flight
to Florida.
You go to Florida. And on the West Coast, a lot of people go two places, either Arizona, Nevada,
mm-hmm.
or Hawaii.
Hawaii.
And I will tell you this, Hawaii beats Florida hands down.
No argument here, sir. So, let me be clear.
Florida's very nice and it's lovely.
It has its parts. My family lives there.
Your family lives there, and I have a lot of friends and folks that I know down there.
I lived there for a long time.
But there's something about those tropical Pacific breezes.
So here's the thing about French Polynesia, Tahiti, Moorea, maybe Bora Bora, which I didn't go to. That is Hawaii's Hawaii.
Hawaii. Okay.
Okay.
So that's where the Hawaiians go.
So you would think if you live in Hawaii,
you're in
Why
paradise.
Would I ever need to leave? And my daughter ended up making friends with a girl, and I was like, oh, where are you from? They're like, Maui. And I'm like, wait, and you're here? And they're like, oh yeah, this is where we go for vacation.
Island to island. Interesting. Yeah. Okay.
Anyway, and then we continued on to the news. I like going to cities. Beaches are great. French Polynesia, the nicest people. I got to practice my French a little bit.
I didn't even know you knew French.
Un peu.
Oh, un peu.
Un peu. Yeah, really. Then
bonjour,
we continued
Jeffrey.
On.
Bonjour.
But it was good to go to cities and drive around New Zealand. Got to go to the Shire at some place.
Let's back up about your French. Back up about your French.
Okay.
How do you say, I would like a
Je voudrais
espresso in coffee?
espresso. Café noir, or, espresso, presumably.
Espresso.
I never ordered an espresso. They did have Coke Light there.
They did.
Single time, I probably texted it to you 3 or 4 times. Great expense, actually.
This is fascinating to me because and we'll get back to yours in a second, but I spent the holiday with my family up in New England. And here you are. I actually had to add, I don't know if I still have it on my phone. I shall show you this because I was very conscious of texting you. I didn't have it on my phone, but I added Tahiti to my clock, so
nice.
I wasn't texting you at 3 o'clock in the morning and all of that stuff.
Well, it's funny. Like when you think of Tahiti, you just like imagine it in your mind, and you think of something that is just so far away, like it's like on the other end of Australia
Remote.
Or something, and it is. There's nothing around there. It's only 2 hours behind us right now. 2 hours. It's in our Dateline and all that. It's not that far behind. People were like, oh my God, what time is it? And I'm like, 3 p.m.
My favorite piece, my favorite data point is there's a point in the Pacific, and it is not Tahiti. It's not Bora Bora. It's way south of there. But there is one spot in the world, and it's in the middle of the ocean somewhere, mm-hmm. where the closest human beings to where you are standing are on the space station. That's how far you are from land. I don't know where it is. It's in the southern hemisphere somewhere. It's in the middle of the Pacific. But I was like, when you think about that data point, you're like, whoa.
Yeah.
Right?
And it is, it just, you know, it feels just very interesting being that far out there. Anyway, so.
But I'm saying is what my point was, is you and I were texting like you were next door.
Yeah.
There was like nobody's business.
It's like, oh yeah, they have free Wi-Fi.
Yeah.
But, you know, and what did I end up doing? I spent most of my time playing games. I got very into Civ 6 on the iPhone.
Right. Which is a good version.
Which shocked the heck out of me. Like, I when it first came out, I was like, I'm not buying this. There's no way you can shrink that game. I had it on PC.
Right.
No way this game could be good on an iPhone.
Guess what?
And then they marked it down 75% off, and they put a demo up, like a 60-turn demo. And if you play Civ 60 turns, right. That is like a tenth of a game,
right.
Maybe. And I started playing. I'm like, oh, wait, this is really good.
Right.
And I was like, guess what? You get my $15 or whatever it is, and I've not stopped playing it since.
You know what I'm playing is I'm playing this chess game on my phone. Really? We're doing, Laura and I are playing chess.
How's that going for you, Larry?
Not going well. as you would expect, she's obliterating me, but it's one of those, you know, turn-based thing where I move and then a day later she'll move and we go back and forth. So she right now, yeah, so here's the board right there.
Oh, wow, it is a very simple looking.
Yeah, so I mean, all
it's chess.
She isn't able to taunt me, which I like. So
she can still text you,
right? So we're playing chess, but yeah, it's so welcome back.
Thank you. Yeah, the one this yes. is gonna sound terrible.
Please.
About 5 days in, I was like, I miss my Xbox.
Yeah, I know.
I'm falling behind further in
because you were in the middle Red Dead when you left. You haven't finished.
I was
it.
Right in the middle. Yeah, and I still haven't finished it. But it was immediately the first thing I did as soon as I got back. That and Donut County, which we can talk about. You're looking at me like what?
I know
Donut County. Yeah. What? Yeah. Isn't it weird, like, that you would be someplace that people want to go, and then you're like, I wish I was playing.
You were in paradise.
I wish I was playing.
You were, so let's be clear, you were in a place that I have always wanted to go since I was a little boy, because I love water, I love scuba diving, and you went snorkeling, which, you know, was
cool.
Poor man scuba diving.
I am poor, especially
No, I mean, I'm
trip.
Just saying it's a lot, it's the simpler version.
I'm like an indoor cat, you know? I'd rather, like, look at the stuff, and then be playing games, but if I'm playing games, but I have the window open, that counts as being outside,
no.
right? That's most of my outdoor activity.
This is one of my top places I want to go scuba diving.
Well, then you should go. You will get more out of it than I will.
I mean, I want to just yeah. Anyway,
well, you know, it's good to be back. I'm going to put it that way.
Yeah.
It was nice and restful. I slept like 10 hours a day.
You had, in paradise, you're still sleeping. I don't know if I could sleep with the sunrises and the sunsets.
The sunset's super, it's
and
in
the
a
coffee
weird, well,
you
it's
were,
in a weird time zone. And so the sunset, even though it was the longest day of the year, the sunset at 6:30 p.m.
Okay.
It's going to set, in March, it will set at 6:30 p.m. here.
Right.
You know? And
right.
so, and then at that point, it's super dark.
Yeah, it's not about the time, it's about the beauty.
But it's dark, Larry. There ain't no lights. You know, and I was like, all right, I'll read, and then you read, and then you fall asleep.
Okay.
And,
did you have Wilson with you?
Well, I'm a little paranoid about flying, especially over the South Pacific.
Right, right.
So I was just sort
as well
of like,
you should
just trying to put it out of my head. Just one more Civ turn. Let
okay.
me live for one more Civ turn.
I spent the holiday in New England, as we talked about.
Yep.
And there's not much to say about that. I was with my family, and it was cold, it was warm, it was snowy, it was rain, it was everything, it was sunny, it was, you know, it was fun.
Did you catch up on anything? Did you work on your backlog?
Unfortunately, I did not. I was spending my backlog of spending with my family because they're so far away, I don't spend a lot of time with them, so it was like, that's kind of what I was focused on. We played You Don't Know Jack, because that's always what mm-hmm. we do with the holiday, but otherwise, you know, the single player experiences were kind of waiting for me.
Did you bring your Switch with you?
I did.
Yeah.
I did. And I didn't pick it up that much. It's not that it's not good. I just didn't have time.
So I did pick mine up to mostly play a little bit of Pokemon. Let's Go Pikachu.
Yeah.
I don't need no Let's Go Eevee. Into the Breach. This is a game that, you know, it's been out on PC for some time, on Windows PC, but the portable version was also on sale.
Let's put a link to the
I
PC
will.
Version.
Into the Breach is like, if you like strategy, not really RPGs, but like Advance Wars or something like that. It looks so simple and it's so good. And it showed up on a lot of end of year, best end of year lists. And I can see why. So I'll put a link out to that.
Please do.
Into the Breach.
We should talk about some of the news and what's going on. Because even though I don't want to do like, oh, let's do a year in review, because we're already 2 weeks into January.
No, we're not. We're not looking back.
We missed that boat.
Well, there was actually, it was interesting. We did put out a blog post just a couple of days ago on Xbox Wire that did, it was sort of a look back, look forward. And like you look at Game Pass, like how many games were added and you know, how many publishers and different genres and things like that. 116 titles were added over the year, 17 right those day and date. And just an interesting look back. So we won't dwell on it, but why don't I go ahead and, you know, I can link out to that.
Please do. Please do.
Indeed.
All right, let's go through some of the news headlines of the week. We got a lot of shows coming up, by the way, in the future. We got a video show we're going to be working on. We're going to hop back on Mixer. I've got a couple of cool guests I'm working on for future shows. Some really cool guests.
All right. Well, I don't know, so I'm very
excited.
Yeah, I know.
I haven't told you. I've deliberately kept them from you. But well, let's go.
Sounds about right.
Let's jump into those headlines and check out some of the new releases.
So what's big this week?
Yes.
CES.
Yeah.
The Consumer Electronics Show.
Which you have been to a few times and I have been to.
Five times.
I've been probably about, I think, eight or ten.
It's not a one-upping game, Larry.
I didn't realize.
If I said that I had been to eight, you would have been like, yeah, I've been to 10.
No, I don't. I actually don't know.
I've been to 10. I've been to 12.
Have you? Good.
No. It's one of those things where it's like you just get back from Christmas and New Year's and then to be able to turn around. God bless those people who work all through the holidays
we've done
to get those ready.
I've done it. You've done it.
Yeah. It's you. Really
eight times.
Eight times. Five. Just five for me. There's some cool stuff. Now, it's not a big gaming show, and I don't know that I've seen any gaming news.
Well, there was a little bit.
VR stuff?
Well, there's some hardware, you know, the new game, those new cards.
Oh, well, yeah. No, there's been some great, there haven't been any game titles really.
No. It's not a software, it's consumer, it's hardware. It's not really software.
Right. And actually, yeah, one of the things I wanted to bring up was, basically the thing you play the game on,
right.
In terms of both TVs and laptops, been some really cool stuff. Did you see this roll up LG? 4K TV.
Yeah.
It looks amazing. If you haven't seen it, I'll link out to just like a GIF or something of a GIF. GIF. I don't want to start.
We're not going
to
do that.
Can't start.
Again.
Not this year. No. 2019. No. It doesn't matter.
No.
But some really cool laptops. Gaming laptops have just gotten smaller and thinner and lighter. And with like the 220 series, 2080s and stuff like that.
You know what I love about this?
What?
I love the fact they get smaller and thinner, but what they never show you is the power supply. Because you can't change physics.
It's true.
They're always huge.
That being said, some of them, you know, it's, different companies have like worked on it.
Right.
And so some are bigger than others. So,
and there is, believe it or not, there is some technology now in chargers that allows them to be more efficient. So they are, chargers are actually getting smaller. But anyway.
Well, and that's one of the things that a lot of them are talking about. So like Asus, Dell, HP, MSI, Acer, like basically Corsair, like all of the big Lenovo, everybody, Razer, of course, announced new stuff. And the big sort of buzzword now is ray tracing, but it's stuff that's like now because of like the GeForce RTX GPUs. And I think like the other side of it, there's more power, but then I think people have realized like you can only make a gaming laptop so big that they're really starting to put that into like reducing the power drain and being able to make the thing a little bit smaller.
Gallium nitride, that's it.
You like your gallium, huh?
Gallium nitride is what they're putting into a lot of the newer phone chargers and electric chargers to make them smaller. Apparently, that's the stuff.
It's really far down the periodic table.
Sounds like something I have to go collect in a game, right? Go get your gallium nitride.
You need 10 units of gallium nitride
to upgrade.
For crafting.
So, yeah, I mean, look at this. This is from CES. This is the same power, and you can see it's almost half the size.
See? You can change physics.
So.
You just need new atoms or something.
You need gallium nitride.
This is not, that's physics today, our chemically, our canceled podcast. So there's some really good stuff. I'll link out to it, but if you're thinking about—
Physics fail.
I feel like it's not like every year, it's not like a straight line of gaming PCs where they get better in a straight line. I feel like there tends to be like jumps.
Yeah, it's like stair-steppy.
Exactly. And like certain years, it's like, whoa, things have gotten much better this year. And I feel like this is probably one of those years where if you've been looking at stuff where they've gotten a lot smaller and they haven't all announced prices. And of course, that's always something to look at. But with, I'm someone who's played, I played Forza Horizon, I played
you did.
State of Decay 2, I played all of those on PC because it was just very convenient for me to be able to play on a laptop, and obviously you can do crazy stuff with frame rate if you've got a powerful enough computer, so something to look at.
Right.
Something to start thinking ahead to your potential wish list for the year.
All right. All right.
So,
why as they say down under.
I was in Australia. I don't think they call it. It's a different accent, and it's almost impossible to copy. The only thing that I can say the weird thing is it's summer down there, but it's summer over Christmas.
Well, it's not weird if you know anything about geography.
It's unusual for us as a northern hemisphere and really
centric
a lot of
person.
And a lot of like our culture is really based around it's Christmas, so it's snowing, and you know. All the Christmas carols and all the popular songs are about it being
maybe it's cold outside.
That's one of them that I wasn't going to mention. And you go there and it's like the middle of summer and kids are off school for like the entire, you know, December and January. And people are going on road trips and they're playing summer jams on the radio. Anyway, there was one radio station. It's the only thing I could learn that the subtleness of the New Zealand accent. It's the edge or whatever.
Right.
It's Edge. You're listening to the Edge. And it's just like such a subtle accent. I won't even try.
Nope.
Okay. I won't even try other than Idge.
You won't try it on the air. You've done it off the air.
Oh, I did it nonstop. Every time you would hear something interesting, you're like repeating it. And I'm like, is that rude?
Yeah, sound like a 3-year-old. Yeah. You're repeating it and repeating it and repeating it.
I've never really grown out of that phase. News. We should talk about Game Pass,
yes.
By the way. So we might have taken some time off. Xbox Game Pass did not take any time off.
No, they don't.
They really don't.
They don't.
They're good folks.
There's like 150 or 200 games already in Game Pass.
There's a ton. So like literally starting on New Year's, we had a bunch of new games come. Ark Survival Evolved, which we've played a lot.
And it's come a long way.
It indeed has evolved.
Yes.
Like significantly. I remember when we first started playing.
We
had no pants. We're running around hitting fish with rocks.
Right.
I mean, and we didn't get much beyond that.
We're not much beyond.
And like a year later, I was watching someone play the dev team. I feel like they live around here somewhere.
Yeah, they do. I think they're over in Bellevue.
And
a few miles away.
Yeah, yeah. And they were here on campus for something, and they were playing the game. And someone was like riding on the back of a pterodactyl with like a submachine gun. And I'm like, that's a long way from hitting a fish with a rock.
Exactly.
So that's out. Farming Simulator 17, which I'm hearing is like low key one of like the best additions to Game Pass.
Right.
And Life is Strange 2. Go for it.
I've done that. Did you play it?
I did not.
I did that first chapter. It's as disturbing as you would imagine.
Yeah, yeah. You know, there's emotions.
Yeah.
So it can't all be action.
Right.
So but they didn't stop there. Absolver, which is a day and date release, has come out, and that's sort of like a multiplayer game, is out. Then, like a little bit before we started recording here, Just Cause 3, After Charge, which is a new game.
I love and Just Cause 3.
Marvel vs. Capcom, Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3, which is a relatively new fighting game, is also out. So
right.
The Game Pass team, they're not taking any time off.
No.
Like in about a week or so, they had three different drops. They just keep coming. They just keep coming.
And the plus we had the Game Pass sale where you get like your first month for $1 and it was crazy.
Yeah. I think that there's something like that still going on.
Yeah. If you're a new subscriber, there's always a deal.
There's something.
Want to get you in, want to check it out.
You're not going to want to leave.
Nope.
So that's Game Pass. I'll link out to that. A couple of new releases actually that I wanted to talk about. One of them, Tales of Vesperia, Definitive Edition.
Oh boy, I know you're huge on this.
Well, before
love this.
We were talking about this before we recorded. There was like a period of time early in
about 10 years
360
ago.
Life cycle.
About 12 years ago, yeah.
Where there were some cool RPGs and like Lost Odyssey was one of them, and that's available via back compatibility, and people really like that. Tales of Vesperia.
Right.
And this game's been remastered for now, and it's $49.99. It just came out. Looked really good. I was always very into it. The Tales series is like probably not a game you've spent a lot of time in, Larry, but there's always like there's some overarching stuff between all the different Tales games, but they always look really cool and they have like a great anime
right.
style to them. So anyway, the Definitive Edition running at a high frame rate looks good.
Right.
And is available now. And then Hitman HD. A lot of people are talking about Hitman and Hitman 2, especially this year. Now there's an HD Enhanced Collection, which puts together a number of different games together in high def. It's Hitman Blood Money and Hitman Absolution HD. Both
right.
of them, I think, were from the 360 gen
yep.
and now are looking together into one game. And so that is available today as well.
Busy week. Busy.
It is a busy week.
And that, you know, let's be clear. We're also, I don't know about you folks at home, but I know that Jeff and I are still struggling with the releases from last year.
So it's kind of like Freaky Friday a bit.
Yeah.
We've switched places. If we go back a month ago,
yep.
I'm spending all of my waking hours playing Assassin's Creed Odyssey.
And I'm in Red Dead.
And you're in Red
Dead.
Red Dead 2. And now we've completely 180'd.
Yeah.
So how is it like on the other side?
You tell me.
I mean, I love it. Red Dead is a very long game. I think I just passed 50% of the story.
Yep.
I'm 30 hours into the game.
Yeah.
I was doing like every single side mission early on. Now I'm kind of, I'm keeping my horse on the straight and narrow towards all the yellow spots.
Yeah.
Because I'd like to finish the game before Resident Evil 2.
Something you don't really
want
to do when it's when you're skiing is aim for the yellow spots.
No. No. Thank you, Larry. It's a bit of a tip for those of you in the snow.
Yeah, exactly.
You don't need it either.
You don't.
So I'm told.
I don't know what
But so I'm loving that. But Assassins, tell me, did you get into it as much as I have?
I mean, it's a much more different game than Red Dead, clearly. You know, you helped me respect my character, which you can do at will.
Which is great.
Which is great for some drachma.
I think that they found the balance with this Assassins of like, what are the parts that can be gamey and what parts need to be more realistic? And when it comes to like how great everything looks and,
right.
you know, the map and all that, it's pretty darn realistic. I mean, you look at a map, it's all of Greece basically.
Right.
But then like at some point you can activate a thing where you get to a certain level where I can just jump off any cliff I'm going to do a flip and I'm going to land on my feet. And you know what?
Zero damage.
Not realistic. I don't care. It's great. It makes it more of a joy to play the game.
Yeah. No, I love it. I think I hit level 40 last night or 41.
Oh, yeah. Anything over 40, can technically.
Maybe this is a little bit of a spoiler, but I worked on the shard issue and I got my sword upgraded.
Oh, good.
So
now you can hit level 3 on all of the special skills.
In fact, if you look in my feed, you'll see that I got the achievement for opening the skill.
I saw that.
I see that.
For hitting a level 3 non-passive, which is good.
Right.
Because now you just got to focus on the story because you're way over leveled for.
I got this flaming sword, which is just zero cooldown.
Those are good. Fire is the underrated modifier in that game. And the reason I'm sure you're aiming to finish by the end of the month. I'm aiming to finish Red Dead by the end of the month because Resident Evil 2 is coming out.
Yeah.
The remake really is. The remaster doesn't really give it enough credit. They've built this game up from the beginning again,
and it
looks so good using that Resident Evil engine, the one you saw in Resident Evil 7, the one that is also powering Devil May Cry 5, which will be coming out in, I want to say, March. RE2 looks good, and there's a demo out now, so that's something you should look at. Yeah, it came out today.
Let's put a link to that.
I will put a link out to the Resident Evil 2 demo. It is something that you're definitely going to want to play. It's or like with the lights on or off, trying to figure that out.
All right.
Did you ever play the original?
Yeah.
Yeah. That was probably my favorite one out of all of them.
Yeah. Scary.
I mean, as scary as 1998 would allow now, like if I was watching a bunch of videos, in fact, I put together a piece on like looking forward and they've released a lot of videos. It looks way more frightening now.
Of course it is.
Way more.
Is that what, I know you love your jump scares.
The game is so good that I will fight through the scary parts. You know, it's okay.
What other news we have this week? Oh, this is interesting news that we chatted about yesterday briefly on Messenger was about the latest changes of our friends over in Bellevue.
Oh,
Bungie. Yeah.
So it seems they're going to be self-publishing Destiny.
Yeah.
So I don't necessarily know what that's going to mean.
Nobody does. I'm sure they do, but we don't.
What I will say is, I would say in the last few months, Destiny 2 has really done some great things.
I haven't
with the
seen
game.
You play that.
Well, I haven't gotten back into it as much as I've kept an eye on Will, who's on my team, who is playing it at work all the time.
All the time.
All the time.
And he sits right near me, and
he
I always
can't
what
help
are you
himself.
Playing? I'm like, what are you doing?
Yeah.
Don't touch my character. That's all I get when I walk over to his desk.
If he's going to leave it on, if he's going to leave himself idled, I have to like I have to sell some exotics or something like that. He would love that.
I'll let you do that.
That would be really mean. Yes. But it would also be great to teach him.
Don't leave your console logged in.
No, he'll just get me back.
You know, that's like the old story of when I first started at the company, you had to, you know, you still do. You have to lock your computer when you leave your desk. The reason that you do that is because it originally started is when Bill Gates, people that worked with Bill, if he walked around and found your computer unlocked, he would send an email. You know, obviously, yeah. As if it was you.
Mischievous. It's a side of him you don't know. Well, you know about Bill. The, you know, Windows, you know about like the mosquito netting and all the good things he's doing. Yeah. He's saving a lot of lives. Yeah.
He's got a little bit of trolling him, I guess. Know. I don't know.
I respect it.
So that's why everyone always, my former managers used to work with like, lock your computer. So I learned that. I made that mistake once, never again. All right, where were we? What are we doing?
We're talking about games coming out. So we're actually, this is not a slow period of time.
No.
This is...
What do we have now?
I'm going to talk about something from next week, actually. So if we look forward, Guacamelee 2 is coming
out. Wow!
So I don't know if that's, if you played the first one. First Guacamelee, and I think it's part of Xbox Game Pass. I'm going to have to double check that. One of the best Metroidvanias ever. Sort of a luchador theme that has great music. The animation is phenomenal. It is like a silky smooth 60 frames a second with just like the tightest controls. And it is really, really good. So it is coming out on Xbox One and I believe Windows 10 as well.
Right.
January 18th. So next, you know, probably a week from when you're hearing this. So that is out of, and there's quite a few games hitting next week. Ace Combat 7 is coming out. There's a old school looking RPG called Alvastia Chronicles that looks literally like Final Fantasy 2 and 3. Onimusha Warlords. So quite a bit. Walking Dead, Final Season Episode 3.
Mm-hmm.
So quite a lot to play on what a time of year that typically doesn't have that much. And then right after that is when we get into the crazy period where we're going to have... Resident Evil, we're going to have Metro Exodus, we're going to have Crackdown.
Got Crackdown coming out.
Yeah, February 15th.
Cloud powered.
It is. We're going to be talking about that.
Yep.
There's just a ton of stuff. I know I didn't... Sekiro Shadows Die Twice is coming out. Let me see what else. We got Devil May Cry 5, The Division 2.
The Division 2.
You've played a little bit.
I played a little bit of that.
The Dark Zone, right?
We'll be talking about that in the coming days on Inside Earth this week on Xbox.
So that'll be really cool. We played a lot of Division when it first came out, and I'm very interested in playing Division 2.
I can't tell you. I'll tell you. I can't say anything now because there's an embargo, but I can tell you stuff off the air.
Okay. All right. Well,
and when it's at Limbargo's Lift, you'll see videos.
All right. Well, looking forward to that. But the thing I loved about the first Division is we go to New York pretty frequently.
We do.
And so there was stuff where I'm like, oh, we've been there. We've had an event in there.
Right.
And, you know, or I stayed here and there's a restaurant here. And, you know, they know that. And I was in D.C. not even a year ago.
You
for
were?
Some meetings. Just like.
Did you go to Smithsonian when it was open?
No. I did.
Really?
I've been in the past.
I love the Smithsonian. I don't want to give it too much highlighting right now because it's currently closed. Yeah, or
you don't want to build up too much pent up demand.
Right, right. People can't do anything good.
About. But I'm just very much looking forward to see because it has a very interesting. It's a very walkable city, the capital area, and just even the areas around it. So I'm very interested to see how they open that up, especially since it doesn't have that same claustrophobic feeling as a lot of streets in New York do, where you have like any given street. The smallest buildings are 10 stories.
Well, you know why, right?
No.
Really? There's a law that any building in Washington, D.C. can't be higher than the Capitol. Oh. So there's a lot of height restrictions.
I wasn't aware of that.
Really?
I thought you were telling me, do you know why all of the buildings in New York are tall? And I'm like,
I don't know the answer to that. I mean, I'm sure there's a very sophisticated answer to that.
Supply and demand?
Mine is simpler.
Yeah. So it will probably open the game up a little bit is what I'm thinking.
Sure.
Anyway, you've played it. I haven't.
Yes.
I'm speculating. I'm trying to get you to say things you're not allowed to say.
Nope.
Not working. You're
nope.
a pro.
Nope.
Division 2 coming out. Anyway, so a very, very packed sort of 6-week period to 2 months. Why don't we say
when does Anthem come out?
Anthem is in that. Ah, that's the other one that's right there in that period. I want to say it's the last week in February.
From EA, our good friends at EA.
Yeah, and BioWare.
BioWare.
February 22nd.
Wow.
So, very excited about that. And I know that they've got sort of there's a demo or a beta. There's a couple of different ways that you're going to be able to play that game. before it comes out and give it a try. I got into the alpha, which was fun, and I was playing by myself. I'm very much looking forward to being able to go out with other folks and play. And you're sending me a picture of gummy bears.
No, this is, I sent you this last night. This
was good.
Because we were playing Overwatch. We're playing Overwatch again.
We're very, very much back in Overwatch.
And your daughter, who's quite good, you had stepped away from the mic, and I was talking to her, and I'm like, what are you eating? And she was eating gummy bears that I think these are the ones that we got when we were in Germany last year. So
it's, you can almost measure the calendar. Like, I try to get, when we go to Gamescom.
Right, in August.
I'm going to make a non-controversial statement, which is Germany makes the best gummy bears. Crickets for the argument.
Can we torque that down to say the Baron Company?
The Baron Company
makes the best.
I think we can do that.
Which is a local company in one state of Germany that makes the best.
In the Rhineland.
Right.
And we buy, every year we go to Gamescom, we buy enough to last essentially to the next one. We're down to our last bag,
okay,
which is sour mango.
See, those are so good. my mouth is puckering.
They're
up.
They're so good.
Yeah,
they're so sour.
All of them are good.
Yeah, and I don't know how we're gonna make
you
that
have
one
you have
bag
more of the Kolsch ones left.
No, I didn't get the Kolsch ones this year. They're not bad, but I try to not get the same stuff every year, except for the cherry.
Right,
you gotta get the cherry ones. Right. Are just so good.
Right.
Anyway,
my wife loves the grapefruit ones.
Really, that's got to be incredibly sour.
Yep.
Anyway, need to take a trip to Cologne.
We've raved about Baron before. Go look at their website. They don't even put it in English. They don't care.
You're going to come to them.
You're going to come to them.
And you know what? We do.
We do. Every year in the train station.
And here's the thing. It's, what, 7 months out from Gamescom?
Yep.
How do I make that? That would be the true Hanukkah miracle if I can make that one bag of gummy bears last for 7 months. I don't know that I'm going to be able to do that.
Mm. Anyway,
especially with my kid eating them while I'm stepping away from the mic.
We're back in Overwatch.
Really good. They've made some substantive changes to certain characters that are working for me, at least.
Some are, some aren't for me. I'm not a big fan of Mercy's ult right now because I played a lot of Mercy and I'm just like, fly around, okay.
Everyone's been in the meta for a long time, but as someone who uses Roadhog from time to time as a tank, he's better.
He's
better now. And I've been having some good games with him, and kind of excited. The Overwatch League is going to be starting back up. They added like 8 new teams.
Yep.
Not one in Seattle. If you guys can fix that, that would be great. Vancouver's close. I'll still be a Philly fan. But when I'm watching them play, it just, there's like a nice, and I think this is like with a lot of esports, when you're watching people play, you're sort of like, oh, I want to go back in there and do that. Ooh, I want to try that move out.
Oh, I forgot about that.
Yeah. That's an interesting meta I've never tried. And so as that ramps back up, I know that we're going to end up playing a heck of a lot more again.
Yeah, we also got a couple new people who are onboarding.
This is true.
So
good people. We had a pretty good run that
night.
We
did. We did. And
Ash is a pretty good player.
Yeah, I'm playing a little bit of Ash.
Ash is, she's fun to use. I don't generally use DPS, but anyway, Overwatch, it's still good. The folks at Blizzard know how to make a game be good
Jeff
for a long period of time.
Jeff Kaplan and Co.
Papa Jeff.
Yeah, Papa Jeff. They're good people. They're good people. So, what else we got for news, Jeffrey? Because otherwise, we're going to wrap things up because it's we're busy. You know. Can we say this? I guess we will say this.
You're going
to
do it.
We have to wrap up the show because you and I have.
Oh, I know what you're going to say.
I think, is it the first or the second meeting of E3 this year that we're of 2019?
First one I'm in.
Yeah, we're prepping for it already.
Well, you know, there's two halves of the year.
And a lot of work's already done.
Yeah.
It's amazing how much work is already done.
Well, I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah. So that's all we can say about that.
Yeah.
So,
I think you like to be quoted.
No, I don't.
You do.
I don't. I just throw out the little stuff every now and then. People want to know what's going on.
They do. And you know what? No one gives a better window into it than you. One last thing I wanted to mention, actually, we announced this week. There's a Metro Exodus Saga bundle.
Oh yeah,
for Xbox One X. So if you're interested in the Metro series, if you like what you've seen from Exodus, this console, it's an Xbox One X, of course, which we know it will be the best place to play all of the Metro games. There's been the redo redux, is that how you say of Metro 2033 and Metro Last Light. And it will come with, so you'll be able to play through all of them on Xbox One X. And it's got a 1 terabyte hard drive as well, trials to Game Pass, Xbox Live Gold, all that stuff. It'll be available February 15th, which is the day that Metro Exodus comes out for $4.99 US. So it's there. You should do it.
What are you waiting for?
For February 15th, presumably. I guess you could pre-order it.
I was just looking at my Instagram. You know I'm on Instagram, right?
I remember when you first got onto it. It was at Comic-Con.
That's right.
We had an intern here that was like, Larry, you're not on Instagram.
Way to figure it out.
And you didn't want to do it.
But did you see my title, by the way, under my name?
Professional gamer. Yeah. How did that happen?
I don't
Did they know. Give that to you?
Maybe I self-identified.
Interesting. Now
I'll show you how to do it later.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, if you follow me on Instagram and you'll see some stories from me every now and then, like Jeff and I going to the studio, et cetera, et cetera. If you follow Jeff, you'll see nothing but coffee.
I mean,
and emojis.
Pretty clear about that.
And hot pots.
I do, Instant Pots,
Instant
Larry.
Pots, sorry.
Hot pot's good too.
Right.
Ooh, this is a good time of year for hot pot. We should go for hot pot.
Okay. Why don't we wrap up here so we can get off to our
so E3. We can get that hot pot.
So we can get that hot pot and off to the E3 meeting. All right, gang, follow us on Twitter. You can follow me at Major Nelson. Follow Jeff.
At Jeff Rubenstein.
Same thing on
the complaint desk.
On the Instagram complaint desk. That's right. Yeah. We got a lot of stuff coming up. Got big interviews coming up. We've got some, I mean, I don't want to say Jeff Keighley style exclusive.
Mm. But maybe you're not telling me, so
maybe they
hopefully.
Are. Maybe they are. Okay. I don't know. We'll see. But we'll see you maybe next week, maybe the week after. We'll let you know. We got a video thing planned. We got a whole bunch of stuff planned. It's going to be a great 2019. We want to thank you for letting us into your life this year and last year and all the other stuff. So anything you want to say, Jeff?
No, I'm just happy to be here. I'm looking forward to 2019.
Woohoo! All right, we'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye.